Welcome to this module on the fundamental rights, the right to equality articles. So we'll be dealing with all the articles in this module which are related to right to equality. So let us begin with equality before law for Article 14. So according to the Constitution, Article 14 treats all the people as same in the eyes of the law, which means you may be a celebrity, you may be a normal individual, you may be in a high profile position, even if you are a prime minister or president of India, the common man, you will be treated alike if you have done any mistake. The same law is applicable to all of you. Then there is a provision that states that all the citizens will be treated equally before the law. Under the same circumstances, the law will treat the people in the same manner. As I mentioned to you, the circumstances and the law are same. The people might be different. He might be in position, he might be in power. It doesn't matter. It will be treated in the same manner. That is equality before the law. Now coming to Article 15, prohibition of discrimination. Any kind of discrimination is being prohibited under Article 15. So no citizen, irrespective of his caste, color, creed, region, religion, place of birth, subjected to any liability, disability, restrictions or conditions with respect to access to any public places, as you can see here, any public places will not be denied the access, and they can use the tanks, the water tanks, wells, guards maintained by the state are meant for general public. So you shall not be discriminated on the grounds of race, religion, caste, place of birth, sex, or any of them, or subjected to any liability or disability. Any conditions whichever is existing, you will not be denied access to any public places. You can use the tanks, wells, guards, etc. that are maintained by the state government. Now here, why they are mentioning very specifically about the public places means, earlier, before independence in India, we have caste discrimination where people were not allowed to use public tanks. They were discriminated and they were not allowed to use the public places. They were confined only for the higher caste people. In order to remove such kind of discriminations, the makers of the Indian Constitution brought Article 15, through which they prohibit all forms of discrimination. Moving to the next article. Article 16 ensures the equality of opportunity in the matters of public employment. That is Article 16. So there shall not be any discrimination against the matters of public employment or appointment on the grounds of race, religion, caste, sex, or the place of birth, or the region where you reside upon. So Article 16 completely talks about giving you the equal opportunity in the matters of public employment. Exceptions can be given for those who are in the backward classes. There are special provisions to deal with such backward classes communities. Article 17 deals with abolition of untouchability. Completely, the untouchability in any form is being considered as an offense after Article 17 has been brought. So according to Article 17, untouchability is abolished in any form that you practice. You cannot have any kind of practice which is an untouchability. It is considered as an offense. Coming to Article 18, it deals with not to confer any titles, that is abolition of the titles. The state shall not confer any titles to those except those who are exceptionally good in academics or with the military titles. The article also prohibits the citizens from accepting any titles from a foreign state. So neither the state confers it nor the citizens of the country are allowed to accept any kind of titles from the foreign states. The article abolishes the titles that were awarded by the British, such as Rai Bahadur, Khan Bahadur, etc. Awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Bharat Ratna, and military honors like Ashoka Chakra, Paramveer Chakra does not belong to this category. So according to the Article 18, any form of titles that have been conferred by the state except the academic or the military titles, no other titles are accepted. So you cannot have any kind of titles, not only you from the state but also from any foreign state, you cannot have this kind of titles. So any Indian cannot accept titles from a foreign nation or a foreign state. The titles that are being awarded by the British, such as Rai Bahadur, Khan Bahadur, were completely abolished according to this article. Awards like Padma Shri, Padma Bhushan, Padma Vibhushan, Bharat Ratna, and the military honors like Ashoka Chakra, Paramveer Chakra do not come under this category. So Article 17 is abolition of untouchability. Article 18 is abolition of titles. So Article 16 Clause 4 is nothing but the article that shall not prevent the state from making any provisions for the reservations of appointments or in the favor of any backward classes of citizens, which is the opinion of the state and it's not adequately represented in the services under the state. So 16 clause 4 gives the state the power to make certain appointments, certain reservations in the favor of the backward classes, which may not be adequately represented in the services under the state. So what did we learn in the right to equality? The right to equality deals mainly with two things about equality. One, the equality of status. Two, the equality of opportunity. So all sections of the society should enjoy the equal opportunity. That is the prime motto of this particular article. Constitution also clarifies that government can implement special schemes and measures for improving the conditions of certain sections of society like children, women, and the socially and educationally backward classes. Article 16 of 14, as we discussed just now in the previous slide, that it clarifies government's authority to make certain special provisions for having fulfillment or take care of the backward classes. It clarifies very clearly that the policies like reservation will not be seen as a violation of rights to equality. If you see the spirit of the Constitution, this is required for the fulfillment of the right to equality and opportunity. That's all we have in this module. Stay tuned. We'll catch you in the next.